हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे विल रिकैप चैप्टर नंबर 2, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रेंड एंड फो। सो चिल्ड्रन, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म मीन्स वेरी स्मॉल ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट कांट बी सीन विद द नेक्ड आई। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म। माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म और वी कैन से माइक्रोब्स, दीज आर वेरी स्मॉल विच कांट बी सीन विद द नेक्ड आई, only can be seen with the help of microscope. Microbes can be unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular, you know that the microbes which are made up of only one cell, and multicellular means which are made up of many cells. The existence depends. Either they can exist alone or either they exist in colonies. So alone exist, that is amoeba, and bacteria and fungi, these live in colonies. Next, where these microbes are found? So these microbes are almost found in all kinds of environment, like ice cold climate, hot springs, deserts, marshy lands, etc. They are also found inside the bodies of the organism. So children, we have just learned that what are microbes and where they are found. So these microbes are useful as well as harmful for us. So in this chapter, we are going to study about the useful microbes and harmful microbes, that how they are going to affect our health and how they are going to benefit us. So let's study, before we are going to study the useful and harmful microbes, let's study that how many types of microorganisms are there. So here we are discussing 4 types of microorganisms: bacteria, fungi, alga, and protozoa. So here are few diagrams you can also see, and a few examples we have taken of fungi, that is bread mold and penicillium, alga, Chlamydomonas, Spirogyra, protozoa is amoeba and paramecium. So these are the few types of microorganisms, and we'll study about these microorganisms in detail also, how they are useful to us. One more is, your children, virus. As nowadays you must have learned about the virus, coronavirus. So actually what that virus means? Virus actually, it is different from the other microorganisms. It lives in the category of living and non-living organism. When it is outside the body, it is considered as non-living organism. And as soon as it enters into the body, into the human body, it starts reproducing. So that's why it is different from the other microorganism, because they produce only in the body of the host organisms like bacteria, plants, or animals. So, and this is a structure of the virus you can see. And this is, there may be extra question also, that virus, why it is considered on the borderline of living or non-living organisms. Next, let's study that how microorganisms are useful or friendly to us. First of all, at home we have seen that your mom must be changing milk into curd. She must be setting the curd. So how that milk is set into the curd? So here is a bacteria called lactobacillus produced in milk and helps to convert into milk. You must have seen the process how the milk is changed into the curd. Milk is taken and a half teaspoon of curd is added into it and kept it aside for 5 to 6 hours. So milk changes into the curd. So this is possible only due to the bacteria lactobacillus. Second is making bread. The fungus called yeast reproduces in flour dough and produces carbon dioxide during this process. And this process is also known as fermentation. Children, we also use this process at our home when Yours mom must be preparing dhokla and bhaturas, idli. So she need to, that dough rises. Okay, she must be using either sometime eno she must be using or something else will be used by, her yeast must be used so that dough should be become fluffy. Cakes, pastries, biscuits, etc. So this yeast helps to make this flour very soft. Next, making alcohol. Yeast is used for commercial purpose in the production of alcohol or wine. So there is a process of fermentation. What's that process is there? The fungus called yeast reproduces in sugar solution and converts into the alcohol. And this process of fermentation was discovered by Louis Pasteur in 1857. So again, the yeast is going to help. One more use is there that many of the bacterias are used for making medicines. Some bacteria and fungi are used to make the antibiotics. And you know what that antibiotics does in our body? They kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganism. So few examples are there. Streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. These all are the examples of the medicines which are made from bacteria and fungi. So children, in this way, the microorganisms are useful to us. Two more ways are there. Let's see. Microorganisms, they increase the soil fertility. So how soil fertility is increased, how soil get rich in nutrients. So some bacteria are there like bacteria and blue-green alga, which fixes the atmospheric nitrogen into the roots, into the soil, in the soluble form to increase the nitrogen in the soil. Because plants directly can't take the nitrogen from the atmosphere, so few bacteria fix the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil. In this way, the soil fertility increases. And these microbes are known as biological nitrogen fixers because they fix nitrogen from the atmosphere to the soil. One more use of this microorganism is there. They help in cleaning the environment. So how it is possible that they are helping in cleaning the environment? Because they decompose on dead organic waste of plants and animals and convert them into the simpler substances, which are again used by the plants and animals. So in this way, they helps in cleaning the environment also. So children, these were the points to be kept in mind that how microorganisms are useful to us. So in next part, we'll consider that how microorganisms are harmful to us. In the meantime, you just revise this concept.